Now we have created our database. Our objective is now to start displaying the users from that database. So basically this time our data has to come from a remote database. This database is going to supply data to our program. That data will appear inside our classes. There must be something that maps database tables to our C# classes. For example, if our table is TBL users, and it is having a column called user, I think column was email, and another column for name. This TBL users is consisting of a number of records. We can view that this TBL users is a class and it has two properties called email and name. And what data we'll get from database will be a collection of TBL user objects. It will be a collection of TBL users objects. Therefore, we must now map each record in this table can be viewed as an object of a class TBL users. This is one object, this is second object, this is third object, fourth object. Each object is having two properties, one for the first column called email, other is for the name. So we can model it like this, that the data coming from the database will be put into a collection of TBL users objects, where TBL users is the name of the table, TBL users is the name of the table, and email and name are the columns on it. These columns map to properties of our model class, and the name of the table is the maps to our model class. Take another example. Suppose we have a table called TBLX. It has column 1, column 2, column 3, and a certain number of records. Say it has 50 records. Then we can map this actual table on database to one C# class. For simplicity, we can say that the name of the class will be TBLX. And the column 1 will be a property public string call 1 get set. Similarly, call 2 and call 3. If call 2 is a number, then instead of string, we'll write public int. If call 3 is a date, we can write public date time call 3 get set. So basically, when we are going to tackle a remote database, we have to have a backing model in our C#. A model that corresponds to that table in some way. When we model our database into C#, that modeling is done with the help of model classes. If your table name is TBLX, then it is not compulsory that your C# class should also have name TBLX. You can give it any name you like, but you must tell somewhere in that class that this class name corresponds to TBLX. Suppose the real table is TBLX and we decide that our class name will be C users. Then when we are defining this class, we should write class C users, and suppose this is the body of that class. Here at the top we will have to write an annotation. Annotations are written with square bracket table, and inside it you can give the name of the table TBLX. So this will convey that this class corresponds to a table called TBLX in the database. This is called modeling and this is called annotation. Annotation. Annotation is a special qualification on a class or a property. Likewise, we can give properties any name, but we must annotate the properties to tell to which column of the actual database table this property maps. So our first step, when we do modeling, when we do communication with the real database, the first step is modeling. So let us now model our TBL users from database to our C# class. This is our TBL users. Our objective is to show all the records from TBL users. This is the table. And now we have to map it into our C# class. Come to Solution Explorer. Right click on the models folder. This folder will already be there. Right click, add class. So I'm calling it C users. Add. This class gets added here. And now I have to tell that to what table this class maps. For this, I have to put an annotation here. I'll write table. Now this one is not coming. I'll have to right click and resolve. And this will add the proper namespace at the top. So this is the table. And I can set its property. The property is TBL users. So this maps my class C users to the database table called TBL users. So here is the mapping that this TBL users maps to this database table. Then we can quickly add the column mappings also. So this email property, this user email now maps to this one. Similarly, we can add a mapping for the name property also. And this is the completed class, where for summary purposes, this one goes here, this one goes here, and name comes here. So the physical database table has been now mapped to a C# class. Now we should get ready for taking data. For this we'll have to come back to our project, right click on controllers, add controller, give it a name home, add. So we are reaching here, an index action has also been created. Since we are not involving the views at this stage, we'll convert it into string and bring back hello world. So this is what we are having at present. Let us run it, and it runs correctly. This hello world is displayed. So basically this means that our basic infrastructure is in place. Now we have to start writing code that brings data from the database and is about to display it. So first of all, we will need to have a connection string. Although more, I already told you that this is not to be done in real case. It is just to clarify the concepts, because lot of this work is already done for you by the MVC framework. But I am since stressing on the very basics of the concepts, so I am going through this story. So I need a connection string, right click, properties, and this is the connection string. I can just copy it and create a private string constring is equal to @ double quotes semicolon and put it there. Now if these conflicts occur, we'll have to change this one to single quotes, and likewise close the other single quote. Now I'm again stressing that this is actually just for demonstration, but generally connection string can be written in a more robust way by using data directory here and all that. But since that is not the point which I'm going to tackle here, so I very quickly added the connection string as it is coming from the solution, from the Database Explorer. Otherwise this connection string is stored in your config file and in a more better way. But since we are about to demonstrate a concept, we have taken it as such. Okay, now very logical steps. We are going to have a connection to our physical database. We have mapped the models, we have made mappings to the table, then our connection string is also ready. Now let us begin to write the code. Before writing code, we'll have to add certain references. Right click on the references, add reference, and scroll. We'll have to add a reference to system.data.link. This one is what we have to add. It's framework here and this is here. Click OK. So after adding the references, now we can write using the class that will connect to our database is data context. So we'll have to right click and resolve using system.data.link. We'll create its object. Ctxt is equal to new data context, and inside here we can pass the connection string. This using has been used so that the moment this context has done its work, it is disposed of correctly, because it implements iDisposable, and any class that implements iDisposable should be best used with the using statement. This using statement will cause the ctxt to dispose of. Otherwise you will have to manually write those things, ctxt.close, ctxt.dispose. So I always recommend to properly put your code into the using structs. This will do the plumbing for you. For example, if some exception arises, even in that case the context will be properly disposed. The compiler guarantees that. So database connections, networks, cryptography, that all should be properly disposed of, because if you do not do that, then your code might slow down over a period of time. So make it like a religion. Be religious about it. Okay. So whenever we have done link in the past, I told you there are three steps. The first step is get data. For example, we got that list. The second thing is to write the query. And third thing is to execute it. So first step we are doing here is to get data. Since data is now going to come as a special collection It is going to come from a database. The collection used is table C users. I'll have to resolve the C users because it has gone into some other model's namespace. So I can write any name date, or I can write T is equal to ctxt dot get table C users. So this step gives me access to the data collection. I have to use a special class table C users. T is equal to ctxt dot get table C users. This context will do all the best of connecting to the database and bringing those objects into a collection of table T. Since we are dealing with actual database, this time the classes used will be a bit different. But the concept is the same. You are getting the collection in the first step. In the second step, we'll write the query. So we can write query where query is equal to t dot where C users, and we can write lambda x goes to x dot user email is not equal to c at the rate c dot com. So this is our query. And third step is that we execute it. For that we use string builder. So I'll have to resolve it also because it is in the namespace system.txt. Resolve, so it will add system.txt at the top. SB is equal to new string builder. And now I can write for each where v in query. So I'm writing for each where v in query. We are going to iterate over this query. So we are writing a for each where we in query. So this is containing a collection of C users except the one that is C at the rate C.com. We can write sb.append format double quotes. We can write email is equal to 0. Name is equal to 1 and hr for this HTML, and then we can write v dot user email comma v dot username. Okay, and here we can return sb dot to string. So this is the small code that we can see here. You are writing the query. You are getting the collection, writing the query, and doing the execution. The steps, they have always remained the same. The only method is how to get this one is changed. Again, repeating that this is not what you do in practice. There are better methods, but this is to just clarify the concept. This part of the code will actually take your connectivity to the physical database. But see, users class is involved in this story, and you have already described in C users which table it will connect to and which properties it will connect to. So that information has already been placed on the annotations on this class. So based on those annotations, this will actually fetch the data. Now let us run it. So I get this error, link database.models.cusers is not mapped as a table. This means my mapping something is wrong. I'll have to go back and check my mappings once again. Did I give wrong names or what went wrong? Check the Database Explorer. The names, TBL users, the names are all okay. So something else is wrong. This means I could have probably got the wrong namespace for this. So I'll reverse this one and right click again here, resolve. Actually there are two options. I should have selected the mapping one. Maybe by mistake I selected the other one. So click this one and still it is showing a red line because it will warn does not contain a constructor that takes one argument. So I have to add one more argument to this. The second is named parameters and it says name is equal to string. So I must write name is equal to here. Named parameters, so I have to put name is equal to, this is the parameter list, only one parameter is possible, name is equal to string. So I'll write name and is equal to string, is equal to TBL users. Copy it, do the same here, copy it, do the same here. Now I can run and see. Now this time I got it right. So it is showing all the records where email is not C. So basically it left out Google and all. So this is the way we can handle our, first of all we should add the correct mappings. You can note the namespace, like this is system.data.link.mapping. And named parameters, name is equal to, had other named parameters been there, this is how we write name is equal to, we wrote TBL something comma, let us say the other parameter was P1, we would have written P1 is equal to, again in double quotes, comma separated values. But this time only one named parameter is possible. So this is what we have written, similarly for column. So if you can see this, this class maps to a table and each property maps to a column, and once this is done, this piece of code actually performs all the linking and you actually get the data from the database. So this closes this lecture.